I've got a special guest this morning as well, Mal. We know that the NHL is about to start up again with the Stanley Cup playoffs, and it's been a long time since the keeper of the cup, Phil Pritchard, has done this. Since early March, the cup has been locked up in its case. This is the first time in almost 6 months that it is coming out of the case. Good morning, Phil, and good morning, to the Stanley Cup. How are
well?
You?
I'd say well. It's great to be here. Great to have it out.
How is that feeling for you? Because it's been a while.
Yeah, it has. You know what? I mean, obviously the world has changed. We're in the middle of summer and we're going to be playing hockey. So
that's it. What's the last 4 or 5 months been like for you since you said the last time you pulled this out was like early March, right?
Yeah, I mean, obviously for a lot of people, it's been crazy. I mean, we want everyone to be safe and healthy. But hockey's back. The Hockey Hall of Fame is open again. Fans can come down and see it there. But for those driving by right now, they get a bonus.
They get a bonus view right now. So what will be the protocols going in? Is there anything special happening right now for because of COVID and the pandemic?
Well, obviously the 24 teams are going to have their play downs and then into the playoffs and get to Edmonton to where the Stanley Cup final begins.
Yeah.
So it won't be going anywhere until we get to the Edmonton series. In September, late September sometime.
Right. So it's,
and we get down to four teams and then the two, and then we're going to have a 2020 Stanley Cup champion. And who would have thought that back in March, middle of March?
Right. It's unbelievable that things are starting up again. And we are going to talk to Elliot Friedman. We talked about we're excited to see if he still has the beard or not. That'll be after 9 o'clock. With this cup, though, how did you become the keeper of the Stanley Cup?
Well, you know what? It's a long story. I guess if my wife was here, she'd say I was in the wrong spot at the wrong time. But you know what? It's been great hanging out with him on year 32 now attending school in Oshawa at Durham College.
Yeah.
And got a co-op, and it kind of went from there. And it's been my traveling buddy. But the last 5-6 months, it's been lonely.
Y'all been quarantined together at home.
I haven't been lonely. I've had my family with me at home, but it's been lonely.
The cup has been lonely, and you've seen some things when it comes to taking this cup on the road. Share some stories. Again, it's morning television.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I know some stories that we could talk about some of the players and stuff. But some of the stories that you've seen, some of the most unique things that has happened to this beautiful
trophy. I guess
trophy.
Some of the stories would be on another TV show. But for now, you know what's great? Every time we take it out there, it's a new chapter in the Stanley Cup, whether it's going to a Six Kids hospital, whether it's going to a minor sport event, whether it's taking it to grandparents' house after the player has won and thanking them. I mean, all of them are so emotional and so powerful. And like I said, by early October, we're going to have a new champion and a new chapter in the travels of Stanley.
Yeah, and this is a year to, you know, if this cup could speak, this is a year that it would say definitely a lot of things for.
Well, if it could speak, I wouldn't be on here. You'd just be talking it.
Yeah, be like, get out of here, Phil. What are you talking about? Is it true that did you lose the cup or it's got lost on a flight?
I wouldn't lose the
cup. Of course you wouldn't. 32 years, this guy's a pro.
You know what? Unfortunately, as we all know in the airline industry, sometimes baggage gets misplaced or misconnected. It has had some stories, and like you said, if it could talk, it would be a bestseller. But now, we've got it safe. We got the case. We're ready to go, and looking forward to the drop of the puck.
Do you have any favorite moments that kind of stand out over the 32 years that you've been a part of with this trophy?
You know what? It's hard to do one. I think every year on the red carpet when Craig Campbell and myself hand it to Commissioner Bettman and he hands it to the captain, we see that hoist. To be that close with it, obviously social distance is going to be part of it this year, but to be part of it, it is so unique and so powerful. And for hockey fans and sport fans, one of the best moments in sports.
It's so cool, man. Phil, thank you for coming by. You're going to be here a little bit longer with us this morning, as we said. But the cup is here, the Stanley Cup. Players are going to be trying to get this beautiful thing starting tomorrow as we've got the play-ins kicking off for the NHL. And we'll give you more updates and kind of a preview of what you can expect coming up after 9 o'clock as well. Phil Pritchard, the keeper of the cup, and Stanley himself right here this morning on Breakfast Television. We'll be back.